outgoing Chief Justice Raymond Zondo had something to say about how Judge Hlophe got fired. And I know you are keen and you are very interested to know how he got fired. So do I. So you'll have to lend me your ears, patience, time a bit as I dive deep into that. He gives us something, it gives us an insight that is very much important, but at the same time, listening to what Zondo said, it raises some of the questions that I think that are very necessary. He says that they tried to solve the problem of Judge Hlophe. They wanted that to be solved before it gets out of hand. But they did not succeed as people who are leaders in this judicial thing. I have a bit of a challenge accepting that. I don't know if you have noticed the problem right there. When they wanted Hlophe, we need to know. He can't say to us, we wanted to help circumvent the worst case scenario, but Judge Hlophe did not want to cooperate with us. Why I'm saying he can't say that, it's because he needs to tell us what they were doing, what they were saying to Hlophe. Remember, there are some allegations that they wanted him to step down. Just like Jacob Zuma, I think there are allegations that he was offered money to move out of the way. And so, when he says they intervene, as they were trying to convince him not to, as they were trying to convince him, softening him and all the stuff, it raises the questions to say, how did they want to achieve that? What did they say to Judge Hlophe? And we need to know, we need to hear his side of the story. Why did he persist on with the things that led to him getting fired or getting impeached? That's another fancy word, impeached. But it's one and the same thing, getting fired. So why was he stubborn to an extent that he got fired? Why? We need to hear his side of the story, because in the absence of that, then we can now speculate. But this is Judge Hlophe, so he's definitely going to tell us why that. But before Judge Hlophe tell us why that, I think you need to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay guys, so having said that, I'm going to play you the video guy, Chief Justice Raymond Zondo, where he speaks about that, the issue of them doing all these shenanigans and trying to solve or circumvent the situation, making sure that the situation doesn't escalate to what it then became. And I think he took a jab and say he painted a picture or a narrative that this guy is stubborn. That's why we had to impeach him, because he's stubborn. We gave him advice, but he did not take our advice. That's the picture that is basically being painted here, and that's why I said I think Judge Hlophe owes us an explanation about that, because Chief Justice Raymond Zondo had said some things that probably leaves a lot to be desired if you are not, if you don't follow facts. Now, I'm going to tell you what Judge Hlopho once said about this situation of how he get impeached, and you know what I'm saying, why he persisted on the path, and he knew that they wanted to get rid of him, but he persisted. He became persistent about it, and he knew that he was going to get impeached at the end of the day. He knew it was coming at the end of the day, but he persisted with his mission. But before we can continue saying a lot of nice things about that, take a look at what Chief Justice Raymond Zondo has got to say here.
I initiated that as heads of court, we should come together and meet and see how it could be resolved before it could, you know, damage the image of the judiciary, and before maybe it could get out of hand. So we met at the boardroom in the Labour Court, Labour Appeal Court, and we had a discussion, and an agreement was reached that some of us should try and talk to both sides, that is Judge Hlopho and the Justices of the Constitutional Court, to try and see whether there could be a way of resolving this matter.
Like what?
Well, basically, at that stage, I mean, now, of course, we know quite a lot now, you know, because there have been litigation. But basically, when you have any dispute, one of the things you want to look at is whether there isn't any misunderstanding and whether the dispute can be resolved without litigation. That's what lawyers do, you know. And that basically what we wanted to do, to say, if this matter can be resolved, let's explore that, because if it's there's going to be litigation, you can imagine, that's what we had in mind at the time. You can imagine you will have a chief justice, a deputy chief justice, a judge president, all being cross-examined in a lengthy hearing that might ultimately damage the judiciary. So if there is a way of resolving it amicably, finding out, even if we use mediation, let's explore that. That's what we wanted to do. But it did not happen, because Judge Hlopho didn't cooperate.
Was that a missed opportunity on his part, do you believe?
Well, I think that it was a missed opportunity, because maybe a resolution may have been found.
What could that have looked like?
Well, I'm not sure, but a resolution, one would have been open. One would have, obviously, when it's mediation, or even negotiation, any settlement would have to be a settlement that is acceptable to both parties.
Because, you know, he feels deeply aggrieved by the outcome now.
Yeah, obviously, yeah. But that's what we wanted to do. We wanted to try and resolve it. And, of course, mediation is can be quite helpful in any dispute.
Okay, guys. So, Judge Hlopho once said he will rather be a free man than being a slave of people, than taking bribes, than being controlled by certain people. He will rather get impeached and be a free man. Do you remember that, those words? Now, those same words, same sentiments were echoed, not necessarily in the line of being fired, but former Chief Justice Mogoeng Mogoeng echoed almost the same sentiment when he said that they offered him money. Do you remember him saying that? He was offered an exorbitant amount of money. And he says he knew that he was being captured. He knew that they were trying to get him to do their will. There's going to be a story that is going to break out. It did before, but it's coming back again. I know the story because it's a story that I'm following behind the scenes. The story is going to expose a lot of judges who were on some people's payroll. It's not a story that is we like to hear, but apparently or alleged, there are judges that were on some payroll. You know, that's what I'm saying. So then you have Judge Hlophe saying he will rather be a free man. And then you're listening to what I just said, and you listen to former Chief Justice Mokgweng Mokgweng saying that there has been an attempt to capture them in advance. And he goes on to say a captured judicial is a judicial that cannot liberate the citizens, because he then said, I remember if I caught vividly, he said, because you will be told even prior to your judgment, you'll be told that this one cannot lose this case. So it means that this a judgment will be made even when facts are saying this person must even when facts are saying we must rule in favor of this person. But because the people who have captured you in advance demands a victory, you must rule in their favor. Did you just hear me saying that? So you hear Judge Raymond Zondo saying they tried to intervene, they tried to circumvent a worst case scenario. They did not want because they could see the situation and the trajectory they're on. They could realize that, or they could see that he was going to get impeached, and they did not want that to happen. The question is, if they say they did not want that to happen, how and what did they say? What was their advice? Now that there is these two versions, one coming from a Chief Justice Mokgweng Mokgweng, the other one coming from a head of JP, I say Western Cape, Dr. Hlophe himself, speaking about something similar here: bribe. Right? That's what I'm saying. I hear what the Chief Justice, the outgoing Chief Justice, is saying. I respect what he's saying. However, I think it is very important for us to know their advices. You do not have to tell us just that we advise him, but you need to tell us, what did you say when you're advising him? Because that's very important. What did you say when you were advising that person? I'm interested to know. I'm interested to hear your thought and your opinion about it in the comment section below.